Hello students, I hope you all are doing good. In today's class, we will see the book bag exercise for standard 6 in English from English book. Your first poem, Life Doesn't Frighten Me. Okay, we will start with Roman number A. In your A, it is given, pick the correct answer. Here I have given only the answer. You can refer to your book and you can mark it in your book itself. For your first answer is C. The option C, you put a tick mark. And second, B. This, you have only two, tick the correct option. So here the answer I have written already. Then next, in your B, it is given, answer the following questions. So I hope you all got your books. So you can refer the question from your books and write it in your copy. Here I have written only the answers, so you can see from the board and then write question as well as the answer in your copy. The first answer is, the two things that the child does to make her fear vanishes are, she makes fun, she doesn't cry. This is the first answer of your first question. Then second question, the answer is, big ghost in a cloud refers to the scene which is making the girl scared. This is the second answer. For your third question, the answer is, the child is not afraid of the boys who are pulling her hair in the new classroom. This is your third answer. And for your fourth answer, the final stanza of the poem states that the child is not frightened of anything in life. Then for your last question, the answer is, the best strategies to overcome fear are having courage and bravery. Okay, next, coming to page number 9 in your book. In your G, it is given, complete the following table. So here a table is given with some tenses. So you have to complete it. Present tense, past participle. Your words are given in one column. So on the dashes, on the blanks, you have to fill it. In your first, it is given grow. So grow, past tense, what it will be? Grew. Then past participle? Grown. Next, in your second, it is given hanged. So in your present, it will be hanged. Next, in your third, the word is given arose. So here, arisen. Next, in your fourth, it is given spring. Sprung. Next, drawn. In your sixth, two dashes are left. And in your past participle, it is given known. So, know, new, then known. Here in your seven, it is given directly for past participle, shaken. So here, in your present tense, it will be shake. Here shook, then shaken. Then last one, in your eighth, it is given new. So for your present, it will be no, new, then known. This is the complete table of your tenses. I hope you understood the tenses that we have discussed. So here I am giving you some homework that you have to do. So the homework is, you have to complete the tenses, that is present, past and participle. Here I have given you some words and you have to fill the two dashes. Okay, so this is the homework for you. And coming to your page number 7, your C part, that is your homework. And page number 8, E and F part, you have to do it as your homework.